Let's all have some fun, yeah. There's so much to see and do and learn for everyone. Yes, you can do it, so much to know. Let's all get to it, come on, let's go.
Franklin Library, may I help you? I'm Catherine Taylor, the children's librarian. I see. Well, you want to speak to Patricia Johnson. She's our director. Yes, well, if you can hold on just a moment, I'll get her for you. You're welcome.
It's just been absolutely marvelous the way the summer reading program's been going. You two have added so much to it.
We got four more kids last week.
Did you? How wonderful. I know. Parents have been so delighted. I've had wonderful feedback from them.
Mike is excellent with the kids.
Excuse me, Patricia. You have a call on line one?
Oh, thanks, Catherine. I've just been talking to Amanda and Mike about how wonderful the summer reading program's been going. Oh, all your hard work has truly paid off.
Thank you. It's been a lot of fun. The kids especially enjoy Amanda and Mike's story time.
Excuse me.
Sure.
Catherine, our new book is finished, and we'd like you to have one of the first copies.
Well, I'm honored. Thank you. Another award winner, I'm sure. I can hardly wait to read it. Thank you.
Writing children's books for a living has given me a lot of joy. But I must say, being a volunteer this summer in the children's story time and reading programs, well, it's helped me better understand what the kids really like.
Oh, we've really loved having you both. I especially enjoy the illustration class Mike gave the kids. It's so interesting how he brings your stories to life, Amanda.
Thanks, Catherine. Amanda's lucky to have such a talented husband.
Come on, Mr. Talented. Oops. We've got to get ready for today's story time. See you later.
Bye now.
So, how about it? You gonna have the party or not?
His birthday's only 4 weeks away.
Wow, where did the time go?
Monsu could have the party at our house, and we know who we're going to invite, so...
My parents said they would help.
Great. What do we do now, though?
Well, I guess...
Excuse me, kids. If you need some help, I'd be glad to volunteer.
Oh, it's not about schoolwork. You're trying to plan a surprise birthday party for our friend Sean. You know, for fun.
Well, the library's for everything, not just schoolwork. It's for fun, too.
Really?
Sure. If you want an idea for anything, you couldn't have come to a better place.
Learning,
Sometimes stories, poems, and rhymes. Summer special shows for families to go. Newspapers to read and friends that you can meet. Puzzles, games, and crafts. You'll want to keep on going back to the
Let's take a tour of the library. In order to find the book you want, you need to know the streets of the library.
Streets and a library?
That's right. Think of your library as a town. And in order to find the post office, bank, or the school, you need to know the street on which it's located.
Oh, like National Geographic is on Magazine Street?
That's exactly right. Once you know the streets of the library, you'll be able to find the address of the book that you want.
I'm ready for a tour.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah!
This is Fiction Street. Fiction means something invented by the imagination. Not real life, but made up.
You mean like a purple polka-dotted dinosaur that chases the bullies away from the playground?
That's right, Brian. You couldn't get any more fictitious than that. A polka-dot dinosaur isn't real. It was invented by your imagination. Next stop, Nonfiction Street. So the opposite of fiction, this is where you'll find all the books on real dinosaurs, how they lived in the past, in real life.
I remember last year in science class, we had to get books on Brachiosaurus. They were real dinosaurs.
So this is where you found all the books you needed on real dinosaurs, here in nonfiction, which means...
real life!
Right. Now here in the reference section, you'll find atlases, dictionaries, encyclopedias, and special books. This is where we can find more information on dinosaurs. Now, these books never leave the library, so they're always here for anyone to use anytime.
So you can look up the facts and information on any subject that you need in the reference section.
That's right. So now you know if you want to read a funny make-believe book about dinosaurs, you'd find that in...
fiction!
Which is something invented by the imagination.
That's right. But if you needed a real book on true dinosaurs, you'd go to...
Nonfiction Street.
Where true stories are.
That's right. But if we needed more facts and information on dinosaurs, we'd...
you'd go to the reference section.
That's right. Now, if we needed a book on party planning, we would go to...
Nonfiction Street.
Because we want to know how to plan a real birthday party.
You got it. Now, let's go back to Nonfiction Street. Here's a book on party planning, with a list right at the beginning of everything you need for a great party. You can write it down or you can use the copy machine.
This is just what we need to get started.
Great, but if you do need some more help, don't hesitate to ask me.
Thank you.
We will.
Okay, you're welcome.
Date, time, place, decorations, birthday cake.
We can fill in the date and place. We have that.
This is great. Sean's gonna love this.
But he's gotta be surprised.
I can hardly wait to see the expression on his face.
Yeah, right.
Phew, there's a lot to this, isn't there?
Yeah, but I think getting ready is half the fun.
This all sounds good, but I wish we could do something special.
Let's ask Miss Taylor. Come on.
Excuse me, Miss Taylor. Thank you for all your help. But instead of the regular birthday party, we'd like to do something special. Something different. Can you help us?
You mean like a theme party?
What's that?
If your theme was the circus, all the food and decorations would have something to do with the circus. Like the food could be cotton candy and hot dogs, and the entertainment could be clowns and some animal acts.
Wow, that would be great.
Okay, I see what you mean. We think of a theme we like. Then we take the list of things needed for a party. And then we match them with the theme.
Right. Every theme you can think of is right at your fingertips here at the library. Just reach for a book.
How about a space theme?
Or a pirate treasure hunt. Would that be great or what?
The circus sounded like fun to me.
What was that book Sean was talking about? Living on a ranch? He really got into that.
Yeah. He said the life of a cowboy was for him.
Then let's do a cowboy theme.
Great. But how do we do that? What do we need?
Sounds like you're onto something. Why don't you follow me, and I'll show you how to find some books on life in the Old West. This is the card catalog. Each book has its own address, and you can look it up right here. You can look it up three ways: by the subject, the book's author, or the title. You can find any book you need once you know the streets in your library, and you can look up your book's address right here in the card catalog.
Some libraries have computers instead of the regular card catalog. How do you look up your book in the computerized catalog?
Well, they both give you the same information, even though it's in different forms.
Hi, Mrs. Taylor. Children?
Hi!
How are the plans for the party coming?
Good, but we need to know how to use the card catalog so we can find more ideas for our party.
Wonderful. May I help?
Well, we'd love it.
First, you know there are two types of books, fiction and nonfiction. Now, even though they're different, you look them both up in the same place in the same way.
You mean in there?
It isn't hard. All you have to find is the call number.
Call number?
What's that?
Well, every book has a call number. Well, it's the address of the book. So if you know the streets in your library and the address of your book,
then we'll be able to find the book we want.
Could you please explain that one more time?
Wait a minute, I have an idea. Here comes James. He'll tell you in a way you'll never forget. James, could you tell these children how you learned to use the card catalog?